Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about the value of a fraction because you can always find a calculator to do calculations for you, but if you don't understand the value of a fraction when you see one, it's hard to work with them effectively. As the value of the numerator approaches the value of the denominator, the fraction approaches 1. So 8 over 8 equals 1 and 17 over 17 equals 1. But what about fractions that are close to but less than 1? Well, I'm going to write a few, and if I want to say something like 7, as I did in the last fraction, the closest I can get to 1 without actually getting there using whole numbers is 6. So 6 sevenths is pretty close to 1. If I had something like 12 and I wrote 10, is that pretty close to 1? It's pretty close, right? Because I could go up to 11. It's not the closest, but they are pretty close to 1. What if I had something like 12,497 in the denominator? If I wrote 12,400, is that pretty close to 1? It is. Even though it's 97 away, we're talking about 12,400, so that's pretty close to 1, right? The closest we could get would be 12,496. But that's what I want you to realize. Whenever you have a denominator, looking at the top, you can tell, oh, that's pretty close to 1. We're getting pretty close to 1 there. We're only 1 away. So that's the idea of the value of a fraction. And then if the numerator is half of the denominator, then the fraction equals 1 half. So for instance, 25 is half of 50. That's 1 half, right? That's because 50 divided by 2 is 25, so without exactly 1 half. Whereas here, 18 divided by 2 is 9, so 9 over 18, that's exactly a half. And I say a half because most of us are familiar with halves. We talk about half a dollar or whatever, you know, 50 cents out of 100, right? 50 is half of 100. So we have that idea of half pretty securely in our minds, most of us do. And so fill in the missing numbers to make the fraction equal 1 half. Well, if I have 20 as a denominator, half of 20 is 10, so that would make that 1 half. You might want to try these. Pause the video and try them and then come back. Half of 4 is 2. Half of 10 is 5. Now, these last three, I'm given the numerator and I have to figure out the denominator. Remember, the numerator should be half of the denominator like they were here. So I would want to multiply 30 by 2 and get 60. To make that 1 half. 30 is half of 60. 13 times 2 would be 26, and 7 times 2 would be 14. So all of those fractions equal 1 half. If the number in the numerator is less than half the denominator, the value of the fraction is less than 1 half. So for instance, 9 over 20 is definitely less than a half because it's less than half of that number on the top. So the last part here says to categorize the numbers, categorize the fractions into the boxes below. And I have some math terminology going on here that you may not be familiar with. So I set it in words, but I also set it in symbols. In this box goes any fractions that are less than, numerator over denominator is what I'm calling a fraction. The fraction is less than 1 half. If it's between 1 half, it could be equal to 1 half or greater than 1 half. Between 1 half and 1, it goes here. But notice it doesn't equal 1. This box, if it actually equals 1, it goes here. The numerator over denominator is greater than or equal to 1, but less than 1 and a half. And finally, here we want to say it's greater than 1 and a half. You might want to turn off the computer, turn off the video and freeze it and try these because this is tricky and it doesn't make you better at it just to watch. Okay. Well, 3 over 2. If I change 3 over 2 into a mixed number, I get 2 goes into 3 one time with 1 left over. I get 1.5. So the box where it actually equals 1.5 or more is over here. So 3 halves is actually exactly equal to 1.5. So it goes there. 13 sevenths. Well, 13 over 7, 7 goes into 13 one time with 6 left over. Do you see how 6 is almost 7? So we're almost to another whole. If I had 14 over 7, I'd have 2, right? So that's definitely greater than 1.5 as well. 1 and 1/7. Well, 1 and 1/7, 1/7 is pretty small. It's not much more than just having no extra sevens there. It is more than one, because if I just had one, I wouldn't have any fraction there. So it's more than one, but it's less than 1.5. So 1 1/7 would go into this box. What about 6/11? Well, what is half of 11? Half of 11 is 5.5, and 6 is a little more than that. So this is a little bigger than 1/2. So it's greater than 1/2, but it's not 1, because 11/11 would be 1. So 6/11ths go into this box. 1/5. Well, half of 5 is 2.5, and this number is definitely less than that. So it's less than 1/2. So 1/5 would go into the box that's less than 1/2. 3/8. Well, half of 8 would be 4, and our number is less than that. So this is another one that's less than 1/2. 13/13 is exactly 1. If it's exactly 1, it fits into this box. It's equal to 1. So 13/13. 3/6. 3/6. 3 is half of 6. This is exactly 1/2. So exactly 1/2 would go into this box. 9/15. What's half of 15? Half of 15 is 7.5, and 9 is greater than that. But definitely this is less than 1, so it goes in here between 1.5 and 1. 1/5/6. Well, 5/6 is almost another whole, right? So it definitely goes here. It's greater than half. Half of 6 would be 3. This is more than half of 6, so it's more than 1.5. 9/19. Half of 19 is 9.5. This is a little bit less than that, so this is less than a half. And 11/16. Half of a 16 would be 8. This is definitely more than a half, but it's not a whole yet, so it's here in this box. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.